Gather round, gather round, gather round. Michael Molthan into the Rock Radio, coming to you live from iHeartRadio, Dallas, Texas, D-Town. Ooh, that got me fired up. Little old G&R. My girl Camera back in the house, back in the box.
What's going on?
Man, Camera, the Camera is my, man, I'm going to cry.
We go way back.
Yeah, we do go way back, and I wanted to give you a special shout. Mama P said, you make sure you tell Camera hello. So Mama P said hello to you because she knew that Miles was going to be at the Dallas Cowboy game up there in that scrimmage. And, man, golly, that's got to be a long day sitting in that scrimmage and at Texas Stadium or AT&T Stadium when it's the last preseason game. So, but I'm glad you're here because now we got the A-team in. Now we can do a show. That dude abuses me. He hurt.
Don't tell Dan.
No, we love our man Miles. Hashtag Miles. And he'll be back tomorrow. But we're so lucky. Danny Miles, who is the producer for the Dallas Cowboys, is out doing the preseason game for the Cowboys on Thursday night football. And I'm going to look forward to watching a little bit of that after the show today. Welcome to the show. This is Michael Molthan. I'm a recovering drug addict alcoholic. And I've been clean and sober all day long, baby. All day long. And we just keep stacking day on day on day. And, man, what do you think of my hat, Cameron? You like this Williams chicken hat?
I did notice
that.
Man,
Danny Campbell, the official paparazzo of M2 The Rock Radio, he got this hat for me. He says, man, wear this hat. I talked to him, and Danny Campbell, in fact, Julie saw him live. And he's one of our best promoters. I mean, that guy, he will promote him some M2 The Rock Radio. He loves him and M2, but we had a great day today, and we were in Chimes. Chimes, it's a boutique hotel in Bishop Arts. I'm telling you guys, if you're in the Dallas-Fort Worth area and you live, go check it out. It is absolutely beautiful. Beautiful. Chimes Hotel, it's a boutique hotel. They got 12 rooms. And it's an old church. They remodeled it. Cameron, you got to go check this out. It is so cool. Andra? It's on Zang, yeah. And it's right there on Zang, right across the street from Lake Cliff Park, in the Cliff, down in Oak Cliff. And they're doing such a great job renovating that area down around that park. It's beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful. Down by Methodist Hospital at Colorado and Zang in Dallas, and it's awesome. So go check them out, Chimes. I wanted to give her a shout. She's got an incredible story. We're actually going to get her on the show, and we were down there doing a little pre- Fashion Stars for a Cause event, which is on March 29th. March 29th, we'll be really opening up the marketing and the branding on that. Fashion Stars for a Cause, Yvonne Crum and Margie Wright with Suicide Crisis Center of North Texas. Terry Bentley Hill, as you know, she's been on the show. Cameron, you've had the pleasure of producing shows with Terry Bentley Hill on it. And she's in Ireland right now, but when she gets back, she's going to be right back on the show. Cameron, I hope you can join us this month. We got a bunch of incredible guests coming in.
I keep seeing your Facebook posts about who's coming. So I'm
excited too. And actually, September 5th, Wednesday, September 5th, you are going to feel a sonic boom. And that sonic boom is going to be Marty Norman and Brian Kendrick entering the atmosphere of Dallas, Texas. They will be landing at DFW Airport around noon. Man, get ready. Here they come. Marty Norman Live, Brian Kendrick Live will be in town next week. So they come in the 5th, and on the 6th, we're going to be doing a Facebook Live show from Real News Network, Real News Communications Network at Jeff Crowley Studio with Marty Norman and Brian Kendrick. And then we will be in studio, iHeartRadio, for M2 The Rock Radio show on the 6th and the 7th. Then we're going to take Marty Norman and Brian Kendrick to Ashley Burgess Studio, the official licensed therapist of M2 The Rock Radio. We're going to go down there and do a show with Ashley Burgess, then come right back here and go to iHeartRadio and do a show. And in the midst of all that, we are going to go make a recovery meeting each day because that's what we do. And that's why these guys are coming here, because we are in recovery 24/7. So Brian Kendrick and Marty Norman are on the way to Dallas. They'll be here next week. We're really excited about that. Danny Campbell, the official paparazzo of M2 The Rock Radio. DFW Coin and Jewelry. DFW Coin and Jewelry. I don't know if you noticed this, Cameron, but look at this. I'm blinging on these ears. And you've heard my story. I said everything about me today is real except my earrings, Not no more. Not no more. And but anyways, I joke. DFW Quinn and Julie, thank you so much. I didn't ask for this, but he's so funny. He says, "Man, get that trash off. Man, you're big time now." I said, "I ain't big time. I'm a little BB and a big old stack of BBs." And he says, "Man, put these on." I said, "Man, that's awesome." So, anyways, I'm just spreading the word for him, man. But Kristen Oyster, DFW Coin and Jewelry. If you're in the need of a Rolex, diamonds, anything like that, you see something in a really big expensive store, it's just too much money, take a picture of it. Call Kristen Oyster, DFW Coin and Jewelry. He will hook you up. He'll hook you up. He can cut you a good deal on watches, anything you need, you know. And so I actually talked to him this morning. I talk to him every day. He's a good friend of mine. So Kristen Oyster, DFW Coin and Jewelry. So I want to make some announcements today. It's been a very busy day in the world of M2 The Rock Radio. Tomorrow is August 31st. And the reason why tomorrow is August 31st is because today is August 30th. You like that? I think that's pretty smart, huh? Makes sense, doesn't it? Tomorrow's August 31st. It's Friday. Today is no tripping Thursday. We ain't tripping today, camera. There's some people tripping out there today. I've seen some people tripping, man.
Right, I know.
Man, we ain't tripping. We don't trip around here. So we ain't tripping. I had my one trip, and that was a couple of days ago when I didn't think the Wi-Fi was working. But you know why? I started tripping because I was trying to play God. And when I play God, guess what he's going to do? He's going to let me. He's going to let me. So, but today's no tripping Thursday. If you're tripping, invite God right in the middle of your life. You know, what are you grateful for today? Look at your feet. Enjoy the now. It's the safest place in the world because that's where God's at. All right. If you also just want to, before I get into the announcements, we talk about drug addiction on the show. We talk about alcoholism. We talk about suicide prevention. We talk about mental health illnesses. We talk about these things because a lot of people don't talk about them. They report things that happen as a result of our actions. That's what they do talk about, all right? And so that has created a stigma. And that stigma is that we're bad people, okay? That's the way I felt a lot of times. A lot of people didn't say I was a bad person. They just didn't know how to deal with me. But I'm a sick person. And I'm a sick person trying to get well, all right? And that's recovery. We're sick people trying to get well. And the great thing about recovery is we get well. And the more you want it and the more willingness to you have, the more weller you're going to get well quicker, okay? So what you put into this program is what you get out of it. And I am a walking testimony of that. And in order to keep what I have, I give it away. And I give it away. And recovery, especially in early recovery, sometimes it's very hard because we're still fragile. We hear things being said about us or to us that in 5 or 10 years we'll brush right off. But in early recovery, we're like, oh man, where's that going? And that's why I'm surrounded by such a great group of people in recovery that I can run things by and they say, you tripping. You just tripping. So, but anyway, special announcements. New season, Dallas County. It is off of Colorado. I actually went Donita Smart. She was on the show. And I am going to be at Lake Cliff Park. New season, Dallas County. Let's talk opioids, which tomorrow is National Overdose Awareness Day. And it was started in 2001 in Australia, and it is to create awareness for people who have overdosed and we've lost to this deadly disease. It's to help educate. It's helped to motivate and delegate and create awareness for this deadly disease so we can provide solutions. We need to provide solutions to this deadly disease. Let's quit watering the leaves for the tree to grow, and let's get to the root. Let's start watering the roots. Let's get down and let's fix the root of the problem, and that's what we're doing tomorrow. Myself, Vita Loca from 97.9, The Beat, we are going to be speaking at this event. I know, Cameron, if you had any runnings, I've never met this lady, but I've heard great things about Vita Loca.
Yeah, I've never met her, but here on the radio all the time.
Good. So I'm excited to meet her. So we're going to be speaking there. We'll be there from 11 to 3, and then after that, jump in the car and race down to Fort Worth. And here's the big announcement. One big announcement is M2 The Rock Radio is going to be live on Channel 5 News. Channel 5 News on the 4 o'clock hour from 4 o'clock to 5 o'clock. They're going to have me in studio on Channel 5 News to talk about the National Overdose Awareness Day and what it means, and for me to share my story and to bring hope. I'm a survivor. I didn't overdose. You know, I'm able to make it to the other side, and I'm really excited to share my experience, strength, and hope for us. It's a special day for the M2 camp tomorrow, and it's a very special day. And when we come back, I'm going to share why it's a special day and then continue these announcements, and we're going to talk about something. Our topic today is, when my friend gets bonded out of jail because of dope, what do we do? Michael Molthan, M2 The Rock Radio. We'll be right back.
Keep your car running newer longer. Head into Firestone Complete Auto Care to get $70 off per axle on a standard brake service. Whatever you drive, drive a Firestone. Coupon required. Restrictions and exclusions apply. Details at driveafirestone.com.
I think sounds good. These are the wraparound ears. So, I mean, I can't hear anything outside of it, which is good. I need these, like, if I ever get married again. You want to borrow? Julie, don't let him talk like that. Social media family, what's up with you today on No Tripping Thursday? We've got a great day today. So real quick, let me run down the schedule with you a little bit. We've got Marty Norman, Brian Kendrick next week coming in town. Go to m2therock.com. That's m2therock.com. You can go to our calendar page on there, our events page. Calendar page is on our website. Events is on the Facebook page. All right? Brian Kendrick, Marty Norman. Then we have Tim Ryan, Andrew Hager, different times coming. So they're both coming the same week, but they're both going to be here at different times. Tim Ryan does everything alone. We don't let him play with the other children, okay? So Tim Ryan has to come by himself, okay? He comes in stealth mode. He just pops up. So all we do is do the password. He'll, text me a password. I'll text it, and he'll just, go poop. It'll just pop up right here in the studio. He's incredible. So Andrew Hager live, Tim Ryan, and then the week after that, Jam Alker, the official rocker of M2 The Rock Radio, one of our very first guests that we had on the show, is going to be on. Jam Alker got a great, every one of these guys have an incredible story, but they deliver it. It's so good how they deliver their story. These guys all moved me when they were guests, previous guests on the show, and how they talk about how the steps of recovery have changed their life and how they're living today in life and how they overcome obstacles in life. And that's what I really love about these guys, because they remain in solution. So, and then the week after that, or on the 12th, we can't forget this, okay? Dr. Jeff Warren, the pastor of Park City Baptist Church here in Dallas, is going to be in studio. Very, very special person to me. He's going to be in studio. So Dr. Jeff Warren, and then we've got the last week of September, Rich Walters and my man Kalichi. Yep, they're going to be in town. They're all going to be in town.
Honoring our first responders by doing acts of service. Make a difference and volunteer. Find out more at 911day.org.
For more information about contests on this station, go to kfxr.com/rules.
You know what this song is. You know what this song is. The official paparazzo of M2 The Rock Radio, Danny Campbell. Yep. Click, click, Dropbox. That's him. Danny Campbell, the official paparazzo of M2 The Rock Radio. Danny Campbell, we all love you. I mean, we talk about you a lot, and it was just so awesome to see you today at the table. And here's a guy that brought together a meeting today, brought people around the table, and man, he's just so passionate about trying to help others, and working with Fashion Stars for a Cause. Yvonne Crom, we love you. Our thoughts and prayers are with you and Mayo. We mean that. And you have been a warrior, and you've been a great supporter of M2 The Rock Radio. We're here to support you. Mary Bentley, great seeing you today. And Margie Wright, Suicide Crisis Center of North Texas. That's Suicide Crisis Center of North Texas. We really enjoyed seeing all of you. So it was a great, great day. And Andra Maldonado for Chimes Hotel, Bistro Hotel. Just a killer place. I mean, it's just, go out there and check it out. I mean, it's just amazing. It's just the architecture. I love architecture. It's incredible. So anyways, tomorrow, Channel 5, National Overdose Awareness. And then today, I was Skype interviewed on Channel 33. Channel 33, which will be aired tomorrow at 4 o'clock. And we were talking about a new, and Cameron, this is going to blow you away. I'm going to be, it's called wasping. Have you heard of wasping? Okay, so wasping is a new crave right now, a new phase, a new fad in the drug-using world. And that's what we do. That's what we do when we start, when we run out of stuff, we get real creative to try to find stuff to change the way we feel that will kill us. And what wasping is basically you take wasp a spray, okay? Wasp spray, that's right. And you spray it on methamphetamine, and you spray it, and then you actually crystallize the meth, cook the meth, break it down. You can inject it, you can smoke it, you can snort it. But what happens is it becomes an incredibly stimulating hallucinogenic drug. And people are getting incarcerated on it immediately, because what happens is when you use it, you immediately go into a blackout and you do things that you don't know what you're doing. And when you come out of it, once you detox, reports have been saying that the people don't even know what happened. They don't even know what they're doing. So let me tell you something. So a lot of people are out there probably just shaking their head going, this is absolutely crazy. Why in the heck would any body want to do that? All right, that's what we do. That's what we do. We get in a place where we are so uncomfortable when we're uncomfortable. All right, and if we get comfortable, we're uncomfortable. And with that back and forth battle of I've got to have something that's going to change the way I feel, and I need something to change the way I feel. I've got to have it. Okay, and I'm willing to go to any length to change the way I feel. And, you know, when one person does it and says that it changes the way I feel, then we start doing it. So it's called wasping. It's the new phase right now going on, and it's going to kill people. And you're going to see a lot of people dying from this, and it's horrible. So I want to bring that to the attention of everybody. If you haven't heard it, Google it, research it. Okay, here are signs of wasping. Convulsions, blackout, they don't know what they're doing. If your son, daughter, husband, wife, whatever, loved one around you is showing these signs, what do you do? Let me tell you what my suggestion is. You dial 911 immediately. That's what you do. You treat it like they've been shot in the chest with a shotgun. You dial 911 immediately and get these people into help so they can get detoxed and get some help. So, wasping. So that's what we are talking about with that. And then we have, let's see here, we also got on, we talked about Marty Norman Live. I just want to make sure we're catching everything. And then Fashion Stars for a Cause. Let me come back to that real quick. What is Fashion Stars for a Cause? Fashion Stars for a Cause is a nonprofit organization that creates awareness for suicide prevention, okay? And they are together with North Texas Suicide Prevention, and they help people with who have thoughts of suicide. So they get them to safe places. Margie Wright was at this meeting today. She's incredible. The Suicide Center of North Texas, they have support groups available. Their phones are on, you know, they're answering the phones 24/7. So they are taking phone calls to, you know, for people who are, you know, thinking about hurting themselves. So they're, you know, they're armed and ready. They're, you know, they're ready to take on the people who are struggling. So a Suicide Crisis Center of North Texas. And then we got this month is National Suicide Awareness Month. So there's a reason why we are really charging up this month coming up. We're going to be talking about suicide awareness. We're going to be talking about mental health. We're going to be talking about drug addiction, alcoholism, We're going to be talking about it just very little, but most importantly, we're going to be talking solutions. And that's what these guests are going to be bringing to the show, are solutions. You know, what are the solutions for this problem? And all of these guys that are coming to the show have gotten spiritual, and they have spiritual solutions to their disease. They have realized that it was a spiritual stronghold, and they've had to reach out to a God of their understanding, somebody who was bigger than that, because they realized that God's program is a lot bigger than our problems. And you know, our disease gets so toxic and so deep, and so we go to wasping. I mean, that's where we end up. So, you know, it's sad, but we did talk about that today and educated the public about that. So big month coming up. I mean, really big month. So we're enjoying that. So had a really good. I get a lot of messages. I get a lot of messages through social media on help. You know, people asking for help, questions on, you know, on what can I do. And one of a common question that I get via social media is, hey, my friend or a loved one has just been arrested for drugs, has been arrested for alcohol, and is in jail and has just gotten bonded out. M2, what do you suggest that I do? I have a couple of things that I'll share with you that I have shared with people. Number one, the person, whoever is messaging me, is I tell them to go get help, okay? It's different with the codependent messaging me than the actual person who was arrested or, got apprehended messaging me. There's a little more hope when that person is messaging me, when I'm talking directly to the actual, if they think they're an addict, whatever they think they are. But at least they're reaching out and taking that risk to ask for help. So let's role play this. Look, first of all, the reality is I had a friend reach out to me that his partner just got bonded out for cocaine possession and Adderall, all right? And which is a felony. I mean, that's a felony. That's a real deal. And especially if the Adderall is prescribed to someone else. And especially if the Adderall is, if you're caught with Adderall and it's not in a prescription bottle with your name on it and you're prescribed it, you're really in trouble. So that's what a controlled substance means. And I want to really talk about that for a second, okay? I want everybody to know that the law, you have, if you're carrying a narcotic and you have been prescribed it by a doctor, all right? You make sure it's in the bottle and it's your medicine with your name on it, okay? So I'm not a legal analyst or expert, but that's the law. But if you are caught with a controlled substance that it's outside the prescription bottle and in a baggie with no name on it, you know, they'll do the research, and if you haven't been prescribed it, you out of there. I mean, they're going to get you. I mean, that is a crime. That is against the law. And you can sit there and say all day long it's not yours when we all know it is, okay? So that's the first part of getting honest is admitting it. So if someone calls me up, like for instance, today someone reached out to me and said, listen, hey, my partner is in trouble. You know, what do I do, okay? Well, my suggestion for that person is that they personally go get help. I mean, if you're married to them, you need to get help to say, you know, what role do I play in this and how can I be a better partner because I'm becoming codependent. I am rescuing. I'm enabling. I'm reaching out trying to get help. I get that. Okay, so I'm going to help you out. All right. The key is once you are released on a bond, okay, the first thing to do is, the right thing to do is to get into action immediately. Get into action immediately and get honest and realize, hey, I've got a problem. All right, I have been arrested. I've been arrested because of drugs, alcohol, cocaine. I need to be proactive, and that means immediately enroll in some sort of outpatient treatment program, inpatient, or immediately enroll in a recovery group program. Get with a therapist and document everything that you are doing in your recovery so you can bring to the judge when you go to court solutions. You can bring to the judge, you know, that you are admitting that you have a problem and that you admit the reason why you got arrested is because you had drugs on you. It's getting honest. A judge can work with you because a judge knows that we can't get incarcerated sober. We know that. I mean, they know that. The state knows that. They don't want to pay to put us in jail. They want us to get help and be a, you know, active community, you know, person in the community. So we want to get proactive. So immediately get connected and get logged into recovery. That's if you want to. If you don't want to, continue doing what you're doing. You're going to continue getting what you're getting. Okay? Believe me, I know this, okay? Because when we come back in the next segment, I'm going to share my story on the first time that I got arrested and how that turned out. So when we come back, we're going to talk more about powerlessness. Michael Molthan, M2 The Rock Radio. Be right back. What's up, everybody?
Want to hear the latest?
How's everybody doing? What are all the cry faces for? Who's crying out there? I got to see teary eyes. Who's sad? How can we help you? I hear, there's a frowny faces. Is someone angry? Who's angry out there today? We got an angry. Who's angry out there today? We'll find out. We'll try. We'll find out. Guys, if you're angry, you're sad or anything, you need help, man, we got tons of resources here in the comments that you can reach out. And Brandy Shook, how are you doing? Good to see you. So anyways, we've got a lot of solutions and resources out there to help the ones who are suffering with anything, suffering for, from depression, from mental illness, suffering from drug addiction. Alcoholism, and that other headset. There we go. So, but anyways, I'm really glad. Let's hit those hearts, hit those likes. Let's share this out. I appreciate you guys. I love you. Brian Kendrick, Marty Norman, be live in studio next week, and then we've got Tim Ryan, Andrew Hager live, Kalichi, Rich Walters, Dr. Jeff Warren from Park City's Baptist Church. Oh, Margie Wright, September 10th. Margie Wright, a Suicide Crisis Center of North Texas. Terry Bentley Hill, the official defense criminal attorney, will be back in town from Ireland soon. But once she gets back in town, she'll be back on the show on the 11th. Terry Bentley Hill, the official defense criminal attorney of M2 The Rock Radio. So she'll be back here in studio talking about suicide survivors. Suicide survivors. So have I told y'all I love y'all? Have I said that to y'all yet today? I love y'all. And I mean that. I mean that. I represent that. I'm all about that. I'm going to get some glasses on here. I'm going to get bright in here. Get bright in here. So everybody like the red beats? How do you like these red beats we got working today? Red beats. All right. Hey, what was your favorite bubble gum growing up as a kid?
1 minute.
Your favorite bubble gum growing up as a kid. Mine was Grape Bubble Yum. Double bubble. Grape Bubble Yum. Bazooka. What was your favorite bubble gum growing up? Hello, Miss Merrill. Hello. Lowly Couch. Broken Heart. What's up, Lowly Couch? Everybody, let's do a #couch. #couch. That means we're gonna put you up in prayers. Okay? We love you, Couch. Lowly Couch. Hello, Tank. Bazooka gum. Lowly, what was your favorite gum? What was your favorite bubble gum? Or what is your favorite bubble gum? All right, let me get this stuff all put together.
10 seconds.
Gotcha.
Michael now has new hours, Monday through Friday from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. and Saturday from 3 p.m. Talk Radio 1190.
Welcome back. Michael Molthan into the Rock Radio, coming to you live from Deep Town, baby. Dallas, Texas, Hollywood, the 214. Deep Town from iHeartRadio, 1190 Talk Radio. If you have not done so, download the iHeartRadio app up in here. This show is brought to you by DFW Coin and Jewelry. That's DFW Coin and Jewelry. It's Fashion Stars for a Cause. Fashion Stars for a Cause, Yvonne Crum, Margie Wright, Mary Bentley, Terry Bentley Hill, Danny Campbell, the official paparazzo of M2 The Rock Radio, and everybody else. Special shout out to Mama P, my nizzle from Bedizzle. Mama P, thank you so much. I'm going to see you in our Facebook, hashtag Mama P. Hashtag Mama P. Tomorrow's a special day. It's Overdose Awareness Day. It's National Overdose Awareness Day. And, the overdose has touched many people in this world. I mean, it has touched a lot of people. And I want y'all to understand who is watching this show. And I appreciate everyone who is supporting this show. But Mama P, you know, she has been touched by this firsthand of drug overdose. And it has touched her like it's touched a lot of people. She has lost two family members to this deadly, deadly disease. And you're seeing what she's doing, giving back, because she doesn't want anyone to feel what she felt. And, she has her days. But we are so proud of Mama P because she works an incredible program. And she gives back. And this woman gives back and you don't even see her. You barely even hear from her. And she just kind of stays out of the way. And but she is incredible. What an incredible, incredible woman. Mama P and Papa P, her husband, and, what they do for the recovery community. And it was amazing. I'll never forget the day I met her, it's neat. It's how God worked. I mean, one day we're going to talk about, really, really get transparent about when Mama P and I met, because she was a low part, she was at a low point in her life. And how God put us together, and how we're out trying to save just one person, and we don't do that. We don't talk. If y'all really could see how many people this show has helped. That's what's been so amazing. The messages, the success stories. There have been so many people who have seeked out, gotten help. All the way to, we've had people that have actually turned themselves into the law, done their time, gotten released, gotten back on the show, and said, hey, M2, I'm back, I'm sober. Okay? Well, it's such a great deal. We could not do that without God, number one, and without Mama P, and Julie, and John, Camera, Miles, Danny Campbell. I mean, this team here is just saving lives. And we need to remember that. It's amazing how God is using this little show. This thing started me walking here with a backpack, and it wasn't long ago. It hasn't even been a year. And look what's happened. And we just stay out of the way. We just keep suiting up. We keep showing up. We get behind the microphone, and we stay focused on the solution, not the problem. And I truly believe that's why this show is being successful. We don't get wrapped up into debates. We don't get wrapped up into throwing slugs. We don't get wrapped up in that stuff, all right? We cease fighting everyone, everything, including alcohol and drugs. Love and tolerance is our code, all right? And when we were wrong, or we feel like we're being attacked, this was our course. We treat them like a sick friend, because I was once sick too. That's recovery. Tell that to a judge. When you get released from jail and you're on bond and you go see the judge for the very first time, okay? When you go see the judge for the very first time and you walk to him and you say, listen, Your Honor, thank you so much for arresting me. Because you know why? I'm a drug addict. I'm an alcoholic. My life is completely unmanageable as a result of drugs and alcohol. I'm going to tell you a story. In 2012, I was full of anger. I was full of resentment. I was full of fear. I was scared to death about life. I just lost my wife, my kids. I lost everything. As a result of drugs and alcohol. And people were telling me that I was sick. They were telling me I was full of ego and pride and grandiosity. And all I heard them say was, you're a bad person. And that's not what they were saying. But that's the way I took it because I was so into self. I was running so scared. And in 2012, I got pulled over with a bunch of cocaine in my car. A bunch of cocaine in my car, and I got arrested. And I was taken to jail. And it was the worst day of my life. It was the worst day of my life. As I was taken to jail as a result of, I didn't go to jail, Cameron, because I had Fruit Loops in my car. I didn't go to jail because I had Sprite in my car. I went to jail because I had cocaine in my car that I bought with the intention on using it all. That's why. Why did I buy it? Because I was irritable, restless, discontent. I had no spiritual foundation. I had no relationship with God. I had a resentment. I was angry. I was uncomfortable. All this stuff. So because I am a drug addict and the allergy was triggered, the phenomenon of craving was occurring, I wanted something to change the way I felt. I'm a drug addict. End of discussion. I go to jail, and it is terrible. I'm coming off my high. Reality is hitting me. All these people are in here. I'm seeing people in there that the police are calling them by name because they keep going in and coming out, going in and coming out. And I am scared to death because I didn't grow up this way. I didn't grow up this way. I was becoming that guy I said I would never, ever be. And it scared me. I went, they took my mugshot. It's just like a TV show. And I was getting my first mugshot. I took my mugshot. I was scared. I put my hands in my face and I was doing everything I could not to cry. Okay? I was actually talking to God. I didn't know what I was saying. I went to magistrate court. They called my name. I stood up. They said, Michael Molthan, you've been charged with a second-degree felony of more than 2 grams of cocaine or a controlled substance. Okay? You have the right to an attorney. Your bond is set at this amount. And my people came and they bonded me out, and I got out a day later. All right? I got out. I got my stuff. I got in the car. And I continued to say, I'm never, ever going back there again. I'm never doing this again. The next day, I was drunk and high. The next day, I was drunk and high. That's called powerless, powerless, powerless. That's called a disease. Because what happened was, is the next day, I started feeling all this guilt, this shame, anxiety, resentments, all the feelings were still there. Life was still there. All right? And when life is there and I have all of this there and no God, you crumble quicker. And I would crumble quicker and quicker and quicker because there was no God. And so the disease would come in, so I needed a God to change the way I felt. I'll just do it this day just to get me through this day because I just got released from jail. So I re-up just to do it that one day. Ooh, okay, I feel better now. I can start thinking now. I can start planning. I can start planning how I'm going to beat this case now. And then when I'm high and drunk, I start planning in my head going, that wasn't my cocaine. Then the disease kicks in. That's when the disease kicks in. And I start thinking about all these stories on how now I can beat it. You know why? Because I'm riding with my God of my understanding. I'm high. I'm intoxicated. So one day turns into 2 days. 2 days turns into 3 days. And I'm high and drunk again and doing it again and doing it again. And then people go, how in the heck could you be doing this when you just got arrested? Ladies and gentlemen, 26 mugshots later, I finally made a decision to turn my will and life over to the care of God. That's the difference now. That's the difference now. So for this guy who asked the question, what do we do when we were on probation? Let me tell you, if I could wave a magic wand again, this is what I would do, okay? Your Honor. I stand before you today. I am a drug addict and alcoholic. I am guilty. Yes, I did buy that. Yes, I did do that. I did that. I have a disease. I've been going to meetings. I've been going to meetings ever since I got out of my bond. In fact, here's paper signed by all these people who have been going to meetings. And here's my attorney right here. And standing right here behind me, this is my accountability partner. This is a guy that is helping me work through some suggested steps that these guys are giving me. And I'm starting to understand that I'm powerless over drugs and alcohol. And not even the law will make me stop drinking and doing drugs. The law's not even going to stop making me stop drinking and doing drugs. But I have found that there's a power greater than myself to restore me to sanity. And that's a group full of drug addicts and alcoholics that are helping me. And Your Honor, I'm begging you to let me to keep going to these meetings, and I will keep showing up and showing you these papers because I want to figure out and answer the question that you're going to ask me when I come back next time. And we're going to talk about that when we come back. Michael Molthan, M2 The Rock Radio. Be right back. Who's upset? Someone's doing a frowny face. I wonder who's upset. Who's having a bad day out there? Man, who's having a bad day out there? Catch my breath. Camera bringing the music today. Nicole Barrett Show. Y'all tune in to Nicole Barrett Show. Nicole Barrett is the boss. I love Nicole Barrett. I love Nicole Barrett. Team player right there. Nicole Barrett.
The new business hat. The buying toner for the copy machine hat. The sifting through tons of resumes hat.
Nicole Barrett. So, okay. We talked about your favorite bubble gum. All right. I need y'all, because when we come back, we're going to ask Camera this. What is the best movie that you have seen this year? Type in the comments, the best movie you have seen this year. What is the best movie? If y'all are going to tell M2, go see a movie, this is what I want you to go see. And I know Camera probably hears me, because Camera has her own show, and she talks about movies, her and Diamond. Can you hear me? Okay. So I'm asking, like, what's the best movie that you have seen so far that you say, hey, M2, go see this movie. Go see this movie, and then what is it? What's the best movie? I haven't seen a movie. I haven't seen one. Have I seen one? I don't know. I've been ripping and running. I've been getting it. I am a movie. What are you laughing at, Camera? Yeah, I'm the movie. Oh my gosh, I feel like a movie. First responders and military I tell you what, the month of September is going to be a movie. God, it's going to be busy. It's going to be a great month. I'm so excited. I've never been so excited. Matt Yates, Avengers, Infinity War. You like that? Really? For details on Domino's hotspots. How was Deadpool 2? Every day. Was it good?
It was really,
I love. I hear the Tom Tom in Africa. Let's see here. Greece? Greece? I love Greece. I got chills that multiply it. And I'm losing control. Because the power. It's electrifying!
We have
40 seconds, thank God. Everybody in? You better shape up, because I need a man. What are they saying? Oh, I didn't mean it that way. Get off the gas. I don't need no man. Come on. God, I'm glad Miles isn't here to hear that.
Forget M2 The Rock Radio fans. Michael now has new hours Monday through Friday from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. and Saturdays from noon to 1 p.m. on Talk Radio 1190.
Oh, let's not go there.
Michael Molthan, M2 The Rock Radio, coming to you live from Dallas, Texas, D-Town, baby. My man, Billy Jean. We rehearsed that. We saved that. We rehearsed that before we went on the air today, but we had to. I love that song. That song reminds me of you, Camera. We play that song all the time when we were riding together, man.
Every day.
You know Michael Jackson, he's amazing. I mean, you know what's amazing about Michael Jackson is he sat down in his production meeting, you know, when he started, and he goes, okay, get me one glove. You know how good you gotta be to get up on stage with one glove and dip it in diamonds? He dipped the glove in diamonds, and he rocked it with one glove. What did that mean? What does a one glove mean? Do you know?
No, at all. It's just the genius of Michael.
It's the genius of Michael. And then even on top of that, he said, dip my socks in diamonds. So y'all need to understand, Michael Jackson is my all-time favorite. I mean, I grew up, when I was a kid, it was all about Michael Jackson. It was all about Michael Jackson. Welcome back, where we talk about drug addiction, alcoholism, hurts, habits, hang-ups, suicide prevention. National Overdose Awareness Day is tomorrow, August 31st. The black balloon. You're going to see posts with the black balloon. The color's purple and silver. So you're going to see a lot of stuff. So and make sure you share those posts when you see that, because that is it's a special day. I know we'll be rocking it. So, Cameron, real quick before we end the show, we had people putting out there. I know you have a show. You and Diamond have a show. By the way, I want to give a shout out to the Nicole Barrett show. We were talking about her. We love Nicole Barrett. She is such a great, great friend. And
she
supports us, and we support her. And I want to give a special shout out. Tune in to the Nicole Barrett show. She is incredible. I mean, she brings it, and I have more fun watching her live on Facebook, because she will do a show and she'll have a camera in her right hand. She'll be moving her clothes, sitting on a phone book, talking, have a guest on the phone live, okay?
Yep.
Sign falling down behind her.
Nicole does it all.
She does it all. It is so sweet. Diamond. Can you research the water temperature in Southern Africa for my next guest? Oh, I love me some Nicole Barrett. Man, she's awesome. We love Nicole Barrett. So I had to give a shout out. I don't know why. I've just been thinking about her a lot today. She's just so cool. So, but anyways, listen, we were talking, what's the greatest movie this year so far, Camera? I almost called you Diamond. Camera?
That's hard. There's been a lot. You know what? I'm going to have to say Marvel's Black Panther.
Anybody on Facebook Live, let's hit the hearts for Marvel's Black Panther, smiley faces. I need to go see a movie. And y'all were laughing at me in the break. I said, I haven't seen a movie. And y'all were laughing and said, heck, we don't need to see one. We just watch you, M2. You're a movie. You know what? I take offense to that. But you know what? It is better than being locked up in prison up here. So, but I wanted to get back to what I was talking about, that, you know, I was sharing my story as far as the powerlessness of this disease, okay, and what the solution is, because I have seen people stand in front of a judge trying to explain to a judge why their UAs are dirty, and it is absolutely painful to watch happen. And I cannot wait for someone to stand in front of a judge when they have a dirty UA and look at the judge and simply say, Your Honor, I don't know. I know I'm on probation. I know if I have a dirty UA, I'm going to go to prison. I don't understand why, when I wake up in the morning, I don't want to do dope. I don't want to drink alcohol. But at 1 o'clock in the afternoon, I do it again, Your Honor. That's what needs to be said to it. That's what I wish I would have done. We can't run game on judges. We look messy. I sit in the courthouses and I see this, and man, I look messy. We look messy. And so today, what I'm challenging, I get a lot of people reaching out to me saying, hey, what do we do? Get into action, all right? You're going to get what you put into this program. It's time to get honest, okay? We admitted that we were powerless over alcohol and drugs. As a result of my decisions, my life is a complete train wreck, yard sale. It's completely unmanageable, okay? Your Honor, I have just recently found out that there's a power greater than myself to restore me to sanity, and that is the fellowship within a room. a room full of a bunch of alcoholics and drug addicts that can relate to me. Man, this is crazy, Your Honor. I go in there and I talk to them and I share my experience, strength, and hope, and they start nodding their head up and down. They understand the way I think. And now I've made a decision to turn my will and life over to the care of God, Your Honor. I mean, so here's the deal, Your Honor. I'm really excited when I come back and see you next time. I'm going to have a slip with all these meetings signed out that I go to, just like I'm giving to you right now, because that's what this person told me. He calls himself an accountability partner or sponsor, whatever you want to call him. But I'm doing what he's telling me to do, and it's only suggestions. And he suggested that this program works better if I don't drink or do drugs. You know, he suggested that. And you know what, Your Honor? It's right. So guess what, Your Honor? When I come back next week to see you again to report in, I'm going to be able to tell you why I do the things I do. I'm going to be able to tell you why I used to give you dirty UAs, because I'm going to do this thing called a fourth step. I'm going to do a moral inventory of my immoral behaviors, which gets me sitting here standing on this X talking to you. Because, Your Honor, when I have given you dirty UAs, here's the truth. I don't know why I use. I don't know why I drink alcohol. I don't know why, but I'm about to find out. In step four, I'm about to find out. And then I'm going to come back and tell you that I found out. You know what, Your Honor? I drink alcohol and do drugs because I'm in fear. I'm in fear. And then I have a resentment. And then I have anger. And I'm finding out all these things about me, Your Honor. This is exciting. I'm really excited, Your Honor. And I go to these accountability meetings every single day, and they become the most important thing to me. I'm early to them. I can't wait to get to them. This is my new family. These are the people I love hanging out with, Your Honor. This is great. You know what that judge is going to do? I'll see you next week. You know why judges, court order, every judge in the country, court orders their clients, all right? Court orders them to attend recovery group meetings. They also get court ordered to go to treatment. They also get court ordered to go to IOP. But they all get court ordered to go to recovery group meetings for two reasons. Let me tell you why. The first reason is it doesn't cost the state any money. That's the first reason. And number two, it works. That's it. It works. Because those judges, they're not one of us. Some of them are. Some of them are recovery. Okay? They're human beings just like all of us. But they know when somebody is working a program, standing in front of them, they know. And they know when someone's not. Because it's real simple. There's messy and there's recovery. And I was messy, running game, running my mouth, and they just shake their head. And here's what's sick, is I actually believed what I said and thought they were crazy because they didn't believe me. I literally thought the judge in the system was crazy and did not believe me, and they would sit there and go, this poor kid is really sick. He is really sick. So step four, and then I come back, and I say, you know what, Your Honor, this is really good, because now, guess what, Your Honor, now I know why. Now I know why my UAs are not dirty anymore, because I've taken a moral inventory of myself, and I can tell you why I drank and did drugs. I can tell you why now, Your Honor. And the reason why I did it is because I'm in fear. And the reason why I do it, my higher power today is not dope and alcohol, it's God. That's my higher power, Your Honor. Okay? And I don't even say higher power anymore. It's God. It's Jesus Christ. That's what's working in my life today. And guess what, Your Honor? Then I found out what my character defects are. My character defects are is that I cuss too much. I'm a compulsive liar. I don't tell the whole truth. I stretch the truth. Okay, I start finding out all these character defects. I'm a procrastinator, okay? And I do all these things, and I'm starting to recognize it, and I humbly ask God to remove these shortcomings, and God did it. And then after I did that, my sponsor told me, said, okay, now we got something. Now we're going to make a list of all the people we had harmed, be willing to make amends to them all. Okay, let's get this thing, sponsor, because we got God, and I'm feeling good about myself, and I got my assets. And number nine is we go make amends to all these people we had harmed. Now we're feeling good. Our faith is growing. Now our faith is growing. And our court date's at 10 o'clock, and we're sitting in the court at 9 o'clock because we want to sit there and be grateful and watch the judge send people down the road. And we see people come in front of the judge, talking to the judge, and we start seeing our character defects live on stage right in front of the judge. And then we start getting gratitude. Man, then we start rocking and rolling. Man, we're feeling good. We're telling our sponsor, Judge, I got this. Whoop-de-woo. And then step 10 is we continue to take personal inventory. And when we were wrong, we promptly admitted it. And then 11, we sought through prayer and meditation to improve our conscious contact with God as we understand him. And then 12, we do exactly what we're going to do tomorrow on National Overdose Awareness Day. We're going to give it away. We're going to give it away because tomorrow we are going to help someone who is suffering. And that's what this program is all about. I got 3 words. I got 8 letters. And I got 1 meaning, homeboy. I love you. We'll see you tomorrow. Michael Molthan, M2 The Rock Radio. Hey! What's up, Monica? What's up, Carrie? Show some love for M2 and what he's doing to help so many people. Thank you, Carrie Cross. I appreciate you. What's up, Doc? I see you, Doc. All right, guys. What a great show. I appreciate you guys. And let me see if I missed everybody, if I got everybody on here. Let's see here. Mike Gambo. What's up, Gambo? Nope. 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 I love it. Oh, you still driving? No. Okay. Mike Gambo, welcome to the show. We need to get Mike. I want to get Mike Gambo on the show. Y'all reach out. Mike Gambo, we want you in this studio. Mike Gambo can go. If I can rap like Mike Gambo for 8 seconds, that would change the way I felt. This guy can freestyle with the best, though. I see him just absolutely. I seen this guy a year ago do, what it's called is a rap challenge on stage. And I just seen this guy just undress this kid. I mean, just undress this kid on stage. It was just awesome. Okay, guys, y'all have a great day. I appreciate all of y'all. I'm going home. Got a busy day tomorrow. And we will be here tomorrow night on M2 The Rock Radio for John, Julie, Mama P, Papa P, Danny Campbell, and Miles. We'll see you tomorrow. Good night.